We have an update for you this morning on the flooding right here in Middle Georgia. We spoke with Montgomery County's Director of Emergency Management about the status of the Oconee River. He says the water is expected to rise to about 21 feet, and that's about 8 feet above flood stage. While the search for the 15-month-old Evelyn Boswell continues, so are the prayers for her safe return. Dozens of community members gathered at a Tennessee park last night. They're dedicating songs and prayers for the missing toddler and law enforcement involved in the case. The reward amount for information leading to Evelyn Boswell has jumped to nearly $60,000. On Friday, DeMarcus Little was charged with malice murder and the death of an Anitra Gunn, and today he is making his first court appearance. Last week, Little was in Peach County Court for unrelated charges regarding an alleged attack on Gunn's home and car. New this morning, several contractors are turning out to a Macon-Bibb County Commission meeting to oppose what they're calling the privatization of the county's Department of Inspection and Fees. The department is responsible for enforcing construction codes, issuing permits, and performing inspections. On the agenda, commissioners were set to approve a professional services agreement with Safebuilt Georgia, LLC through June 30th of 2025. Macon-Bibb County ranks in the top 10 counties across the state of Georgia when it comes to pedestrian fatalities and injuries. The family of Henry Brown is just one of several who've either experienced the loss of a loved one or had to deal with a family member who was injured after being hit by a vehicle. And over 2,000 people have died from the coronavirus, with health officials saying that any medical solution is still a while away. In the meantime, two noticeable deaths from the virus in China, the doctor who tried to warn the world about the virus, and now the director of the hospital fighting that virus. According to GSP, the accident happened on I-95 in Liberty County early yesterday morning. Liberty County Sheriff's Deputy Lieutenant Jason Colvin says officers received reports of a white Lexus traveling southbound in the northbound lane of 95. And 12 people have been arrested in a gambling bust in Macon. According to the Bibb County Sheriff's Office, a gambling search warrant was executed at the Tax Bar Tax Service on Tuesday. Deputies recovered money, cell phones, and large amounts of poker chips from the business. The coroner also says Cody Taylor, who was the suspect in Faye's murder, committed suicide. His autopsy showed he died from a self-inflicted wound to his neck. Taylor was Faye's neighbor, and his body was discovered at his home shortly after Faye's remains were found. Police say a key piece of evidence in Taylor's trash led them to the little girl's body on Thursday. Right now, police are saying Taylor is the only suspect, and they believe he acted alone in the murder. The Better Business Bureau is warning of a scam targeting those who want to contribute to political campaigns. The BBB says the scam works like this. You get a robocall, supposedly from a campaign asking you to give money. Only it's not a campaign, it's a scammer. So if you say yes, then the call then transfer you to a live person who takes your credit card information. Friends and family, along with thousands of fans from around the country and possibly the world, gathered inside of the Staples Center yesterday in Los Angeles for an emotional but joyful celebration of life of Kobe and Gianna Bryant. In front of 20,000 people, Beyonce opened up the memorial before those that knew Kobe and Gianna, and they came up to give speeches on their emotions and memories of the pair. And Jussie Smollett is heading back to court today. The former Empire actor is facing new charges. Earlier this month, he was indicted by a grand jury for making false reports. A little over a year ago, Smollett told police he was attacked by two men because he is black and openly gay. The online retail giant looking to get rid of the supermarket checkout line, opening its first cashierless grocery store. Shoppers can grab items and head out the door without checking out. They just need to scan a smartphone app to enter. Then cameras and sensors track what's taken off of the shelves.